Hello there! This is DBT, and this Art of Runes. And alright, let's continue playing some more Asphalt 8, and today I'm going to be doing another multiplayer MP tune test of this card that you see on the screen right now. A very rare Masanti Evantra. That's it. This is not the Mila Cavalli. This is a Class B one, but this is still a rare car nowadays. I'll explain, but before I jump into it, you know what to do. If you like my content, please hit the like button on this video because it helps the channel to be discovered. And also subscribe because, hey, why not? Now, if you would like to support me directly, please consider joining the Vroom memberships. Information is over there by the join button. But alright, so what does it do with this car? Well, this is a car where it normally is in the bracket of 1680 at a maximum rank of 1678. Now, it's on the lower side of the bracket, but still. But I have an MP tune for 1590, which is the previous bracket, also in Class B, which makes this possibly a useful MP tune. I've talked a lot about how MP tunes don't tend to be super good, but no worries, we'll have a look at that. And for it, we're gonna go into Classic Season with the car selected. And once again, here's the stats if you want to see, you know, acceleration and all of that stuff. But let's find some races. Let's see what we can do. Okay, so first things first, why do I say that this is a rare car? Because this car, along with the other Masanti, you can no longer get in the game. Apparently, there's been problems with the licensing for Masanti vehicles, even in Asphalt 9. The Masanti Evantra Mila Cavalli was removed. And in this game, you know, it doesn't necessarily get removed, it's just no longer available to purchase. And I've had the, I've had the Mila Cavalli for quite a while, and at some point I decided to also buy this one, obviously when it was still available, and then it became rare. It became discontinued, let's call it, and I was like, well, I guess now I have another rare car. And I say another because I do have a couple of cars like this that are not, you know, available anymore. Amongst them, a car that I want to make a test of, but I need to be super brave about it. Oh, I hope I didn't make a crash, buddy. I need to be super brave about it because it's a very low-ranked car, and that is a Tesla model, whatever it is. Yes, I have that one, and I will make a video on it at some point, but man, those races are so slow. In fact, why don't you let me know in the comments if you want to see a test of the Tesla. That would be the only way I would really feel compelled to do it. But all right, I got first place, baby! Defeating a Mercedes-Benz Biome and a Formula E, both of them triple boosted, and the other cars were not boosted or on the rank, or even both. Now, as I was saying earlier, this is a type of MP tune that could actually be useful. You know that when I do MP tunes, I tend to always mention that MP tunes in general are not good to rank up. Because if I have a car of Class S that I MP tune for Class A races, I still don't get to use it until I reach Elite League. And at that point, I don't really need to rank up anymore, do I? So, in those cases, it's not very useful. But for Class B, C, and even Class D races, depending on the car, depending on the tune, it might actually end up being good. I guess it's taking revenge from the last, for the last race, huh? Race. Yeah, so long as they're, even if they're different brackets, but they're within the same class, like this one, class, oh, I'm so sorry, buddy. Oh, no, I didn't mean to fall on top of him. Sorry. For example, this two brackets, the 1680 and 1590, are both in Class B, so whenever I get into the Gold League, I can use either one of those two brackets. And I can also bring a car from 1680 into 1590, and it'll work. So this is the type of MP tunes that can indeed be useful in that particular context, so there is that. Now, whether or not the MP tune for this car is good or not, that remains to be seen. At least I'm able to put some fight against the Formula E, but then he pushed me into the wall and then I got knocked down, so there is that. But hey, a second place. Then again, we're not getting a lot of players just yet, so it's a bit unclear the level of performance. I did beat these two guys. Sorry, Mr. Individual, I didn't mean to knock you down. And the other guy did not have tuning kit, so it's not really that much of a big surprise that I was able to beat them like that. And when in doubt, summon the Vroomers. That's right, I called out on the Vroomers, reached out to the Vroomers, however you say it. And now we got more people playing in this normally empty bracket. And now we're really gonna put this car to the test and see how good or bad it performs in this MP tune, because you know that the Vroomers are much more skilled than I am. So if I can at least beat a couple of them, I'll be fine. So yes, I really mean to test this car in the sense of seeing if it performs good, if it performs bad. And because I invited everybody to join me, the test of drift and acceleration is gonna be done at the very end of this video. So if you wanna see that, stick around till the very end, or just, you know, fast forward to that point. But I would appreciate if you watch the entirety of the video, because, you know, retention in YouTube is important. But yes, so I do wanna see how the car performs against all the cars, you know, and with skilled players, because, well, it's gonna be, you know, like the worst case scenario, right? You're driving this car and you're driving with a bunch of people who knows how to play, and they're gonna give you a challenge. So it's good to know if the car is gonna perform good or bad. For now, I got a fourth place, which I think is not absolutely terrible. So let's see. Yeah, we got Lego with an MP2 CLK, Zazen with an F40, Alan with the E-Gen, Bookchase, IDB with a CX-75, and I don't know who the other people are. All right, fantastic. Let's get into another race. Ooh, and now we got into Tokyo. Oh boy, that's gonna be a long race, isn't it? I could never figure out if it's forward or reverse Tokyo based on this. Oh, it's reverse, never mind. I answered my own question, it's all good. All right, so triple tap acceleration. I mean, the Formula E-Gen absolutely obliterates the acceleration of this car. So there is that. And something that I haven't explained is that I actually wasn't even trying to MP-tune this car. I've said before that I've stumbled upon a couple of MP-tunes just because I've been upgrading cars. And you know, because nowadays we get so many Class B direct upgrades, thanks to watching ads and all of that stuff, I've been more willing to upgrade, well, my Class B cars. Amongst them, this one. So the original idea was simply to upgrade it and eventually, well, and I still want to pro it at some point. But as I was upgrading it, I was like, well, you know what? I should probably look for an MP-tune. So I had already applied a couple of upgrades in the very first part, whatever it is. And I've explained that if you want to try to MP-tune a car, you should start from the bottom up. I don't know that I'm explaining myself. You probably know what I'm talking about. And if you don't worry. I'll explain at the end of this video. But I had already started upgrading from the top down. And I'm like, oh, no. I need to. If I want to try to MP-tune, I need to do it the other way around. So this is an MP-tune that I did look for it, but it was already not super optimal because I had already started upgrading it wrong. But even then, you can see that the car is still doing somewhat decent job, so that's pretty neat. I mean, the Nitro so far doesn't seem actually bad. In fact, it seems more on the good side. You know what? I'm not gonna be knocking down stuff here. Let's see how long does this last me, because, yeah, I mean, once again, not... wow, unbelievably amazing, but it definitely seems very, very useful. So that's neat. And all right, that's gonna be a second place for me. You know what? I'll take it. I did get defeated by a Formula E, but let's see. Alan with the Formula E, I did beat another Formula E, Ferrari 40, and I don't know who that person is. All right, let's get to another race. All right, see, the moment that you summon people, the moment that these races really start happening quickly. I love that. You love to see. All right. Someone else also brought a Masanti. Did someone else bring a Masanti? Let's go. I wonder if it's the exact same. I doubt it's going to be the exact same tune, but hey. And remember, we're going to have a look also at the tune at the end of this video. So if you're curious to see that, we'll get to it. It's just that when we have the Vroomers here playing with me, I need to make... oh, Jesus Christ. Things on my side a little bit more... oh, God. Hold on. Okay, triple tap seems horrendous, by the way. That is what I'm noticing. No! Book chase! How dare you, man! You know what would be funny? If there could be a... I don't know what is the stock tune of the Masanti Mille Cavalli. It would be fun if you could put a Mille Cavalli versus the normal one. But I really don't know what is the rank of the stock rank of the other one. Oh, well. Fine, I'll live with the third place. But yeah, it seems that the triple tap nitro on this thing is what's hurting. Because you saw how I went full triple tap at the start of this race, and suddenly I was without any nitro, so that's not fantastic. Alan with the Formula E, Book Chase also with the Vantra, and I don't know the other people. So, all right, hold on. So, I'm laughing because I just saw Lego saying on Discord, where we're organizing to set this up, like, there's only one user who must be thinking, like, WTF is this lobby? Yes, 100%, because certainly this bracket was kind of empty a little while ago, now it's kind of full, and a bunch of people from Elite League playing over here. It's all good. I'm telling you, it's the power of the Vroomers. I can do better. It's the power of the Vroomers. Did that work? I don't know if that worked or not, but oh well. So, oh Jesus Christ. Oh, are you kidding me? Oh man. Well, that's not a great showing for my MP2 card, huh? Let's pretend that that didn't happen. It's all good. Don't worry too much about it. But I even completely forgot what I was talking about in the previous race, because for you, the dear viewer, the previous, between this and the previous race, it was what, like 30 seconds? For me, it was more like 5 minutes, so I completely lost track of what I was saying. But hey, stuff like this happens when you have to, you know, break the flow of the video in order to invite people, because this bracket is too empty for its own good. It's kind of funny, because I would still expect for a lot more people to be playing in this bracket, given that a lot of people got, ooh, RIP, a lot of people got their Formula E from those three events earlier this year. So I would imagine that there's a lot more people playing over here, but apparently, oh well. I'm just giving some instructions here, but okay. So we got Alan first place with the Formula E, same for the Zen, Rubensito with the Zenvo, there's Veru with the Faraday, me on the Vantrap, Bookchase also with the Vantrap, Beeb on the 911 GT3 RS, and Lego with the CLK GTR. Lovely stuff, let's get to another race. Now it's time for DBT to focus and actually do a good race, because I know I can, maybe, I don't know. But yeah, overall, it seems decent enough where at least it's not extremely slow, and so long as you're not wasting all of your nitro doing triple tap, I think it should be relatively competitive. Now, if you don't have a car for 1590, well, maybe this is worth trying, but overall I imagine most people, whenever they get to Class B races, instantly they jump into 1680 races, right? But I kind of hate those races for the car that you may or may not be aware that I hate, that it's incredibly overpowered and GameLove doesn't seem interested on fixing that. Oh, for sakes, man, really? GameLove doesn't seem super interested on fixing that car, so whatever. I promise that I wasn't going to be ranting about that car too much. I have actually avoided ranting about it for a while now, but now, the problem of getting lobbies with so much people is precisely that things like this happen, and next thing you know, you get knocked down for absolutely no reason. I'm gonna go on this side just for the nitro, because I imagine everybody's gonna go for the nitro on the top. So I'm going down here, and I'm even gonna be brave and do some flat spins. How about that? Well, oh, someone crashed. Oh, that's a Faraday. Isn't that the Faraday that knocked me down? Did I dream it, or was it a Faraday that knocked me down? You guys can rewind it. Rewind it and tell me if that was karma or if it wasn't. Well, I tried to force a barrel, but obviously it did not work, so that's not great. Oh, and I think my boosters are also going to run out, so probably I should adjust that. But okay, you know what, a sixth place, oof. Then again, people are bringing some strong cars and tuned at that, so you know what, hold on, let me make a bit of a request here with the Vroomers. Alright, so basically I told the Vroomers to bring regular cars for this bracket, that is to say not MP2 cars. Because the reality is that most of the times where you're gonna be facing, and you, I mean the viewer, are gonna be playing in this bracket, you're gonna be facing people bringing regular cars for this bracket. Yeah, there's people, like myself, maybe you if you wanna look into this MP2, that are gonna have some MP2 cars, but for the most part what I wanna see is how this MP2 car performs against the regular cars of the bracket. That is the real intention behind these videos. Not so much the edge cases, because the edge cases, well, by its own definitions, are gonna be difficult to encounter. Oh, Jesus! To encounter. So that's why I'm like, no, I wanna see how this car performs against what it would normally, in theory, it should be facing in the bracket. So, yes. Because, yeah, of course, we can all bring our properly good MP2 cars, but then at that point, we're competing against things that are not all that realistic in the everyday scenario. So there we go. But yeah, so far, like I was saying, my impressions of this car is that you should absolutely avoid doing triple tap nitro, because every time that I do, I just end up without any nitro towards the second half of the race, and that's no fun. Oh boy. I was keeping that fourth place, but I'm seriously struggling for nitro over here. Oh, I just witnessed a non-aliving. Oh, am I gonna climb to third place? There comes a futurist. No, thank you, futurist, stay away. You may be named after the future, but to me, you're the past. Hey, listen, that's a podium. I'll take it. All right, so what happened in this race? We got Okay, some people missed the brief where I said no MP Toon cars, but okay. We got Rubensito on the H2, Veru on the Faraday, Leg on the Gangster Vegas, Lemon on the E-Gen, Beef on the 911 GT3 RS, and Dark on a Jag. So hold on. Just look at us go. Almost feeling the entire lobby just us vroomers. I'm telling you. We do be a community. So now Barcelona, this is forward. So at the very start, we got a section that I definitely need to go with triple tap, but man, I really need to focus on the perfect nitro, because otherwise this thing do be hurting a little bit. Overall, I have a pretty positive impression of this MP tune. I thought it was gonna be way worse, because like I explained earlier, it was kind of messed up. I kind of messed up since I wasn't quite MP tuning it at the very start of the upgrading process. Oh wow, that's one loud airplane, Jesus Christ. So even with my triple tap, it's not like I out accelerated anybody, but hey, look at that perfect nitro go. Ah, that's much better, much better. Now, I'm not willing to say that it's a straight up good nitro or anything like that, but nah, I would say, okay, you know what? I'm gonna brave it. I'm gonna say it's good nitro, good enough. Now, the question is, can I get past anybody? Because as usual, MP tune cars do tend to be slower than non-MP tune cars or proed out cars. While if you do a nice MP tune with a car that has the possibility for it on being able to out accelerate native cars of the bracket, generally speaking, they're always going to be slower. So, yeah, that is the part where if I'm behind, it seems unlikely that I'm going to get back on getting past some people or whatever. It's fine. Oh, someone got on the line. What? Jesus, he almost passed me, but no dice. No dice. All right, so what happened there? We got Rubensito with the H2. We got Dark on the 12C Spider, Lemon on the Formula E, Lego on the Vegas. Should I say Gangsta Vegas, or is it just Ramon? Just Ramon, I guess, right? Alan on the Formula E, Pardos on the 177 MP Tune, me on the Vantra, Veru on the Future Race, Rian on the 911, and Veeb on the 911. Lovely stuff. Let's get to another race. And the game is like, don't worry, you wanted more Tokyo, you get more Tokyo. Fine. This video will be ever so slightly longer than usual. It's all right. But you know what? Maybe this is a good opportunity for me to test Perfect Nitro all the way through. Maybe this is actually a good thing. Am I at the front? Hold on, triple time, let's go! So much for... I'm gonna go for Perfect Nitro. No, it's fine. Hey, listen, I was able to keep the first place there, so that's neat. Now let's pray that the Nitro can actually, you know, last for long enough. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do some flat spins here. Oh, no! Lego just got past me on the Ramona. Though, to be fair, the Ramona, it is, from what I understand, because mine is not upgraded, but from what I understand, the Ramona is actually one of the really strong cars of this bracket. I wouldn't go as far as calling it a king car of the bracket, but definitely amongst the strongest. I think the proper king still remains to be the Formula E, but which other one is king here? Huh, I really have no clue. All right, so listen, my nitro lasted a decent amount of time. It wasn't outstanding nitro, but it wasn't absolutely terrible, so that already makes me happy enough. All right. No, Zazen stole the... Oh, Zazen, really? He stole the nitro that I was going for. I should have gone for the blue one, but I'm like, no, someone's gonna go for the blue one. I'll go for the yellow. Well, RIP. And actually, Zazen is... Oh, what is it driving? Is that the Formula E? I couldn't tell. Oh, Jesus. Hey, listen. All things Hold on. Oh, I'm running out of nitro again. No! Just lost my second place last second. Oh, really? Really? That's fine. It's fine. Listen, the nitro is okay. That's about it. Got defeated by E-Gen and H2 by Zazen and Rubensito, but I defeated the 177 Gen Tiaculon. That's MP Tune. The Vegas, Formula E, 12C Spider, 911 GT3 RS, and another Formula E Gen, but that one disconnected, so damn, shout outs to the rumors. And why not another very, very long track, because the game is like, you keep talking about nitro durations, DBT. How about I continue to give you challenging tracks for nitro durations? Have we even hit a single short track in this video? Oh, yeah, I think we did one in Rio de Janeiro, did we not? Man, it's difficult to remember. It gets blurry, especially with all of the pauses that I've had to make to record this video. It's all good. It's always fun to bring the rumors into some of these races because, hey, once again, empty brackets, but we can fill them up. So, yes. All right, so more perfect nitro, please, because this thing is not all that trustworthy with any other. Actually, I've noticed that maybe it's like I never paid enough attention, but it's... Oh, for sakes, man! Well, and this is why we need to do a protest of really any time on this route. Oh, man. All right, that's going to be a last place for DBT. Jesus Christ. All right, next up, we're going to do the drift test because it definitely feels like it's not all that good. Yeah, now I'm dead last. Let's go. Well, I already am going the long route. Might as well go in the other long route because, you know, the race is already ruined. At least we can take the panoramic, is that the word? Scenic route. Yeah, the scenic route. Totally. I really wish that Gameloft was to make an alternate version of this track in which you are forced to go into this route as opposed to going on the cave. Because, yeah, the cave is great and all of that stuff, but the reality is that whole section, when have you driven in it if not just out of curiosity? Or when you were a beginner? Oh, Jesus Christ! Never. That's when. So, I think it would be neat to have some of these tracks that don't really have alternate versions other than forward and reverse, but yeah. All right, ninth place. That's fine. I love when things like this happen. We got Dark on the 12C Spider, kind of rare nowadays. Rubensito on the Pininfarina. We got Full on the Formula E Gen 2 Partus on the Spiker. Allen in the Formula E, Beru on the Genti, Rien on the 911, Lego on the Ramona, me on the Vantra, Bookchase on the Spannon, Lemon. Is that a full rumor lobby? It certainly is. GG's, rumors. GG's. And here it is. You ask for the tune, here is the actual tune. So this is what I was saying. I started upgrading this because I was going from up, down. That's when I'm just randomly upgrading. I 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. And, but when you want MP2, what you want to do is start from the bottom up. Start with exhaust or drivetrain, and then once they are complete, then start upgrading the rest. But yeah, so the tune is 4, 7, 10, 10. And that just happened to land it exactly in this rank. The reality is that if I hadn't upgraded the tires, I could have upgraded a bit more the suspension for additional nitro speed. But hey, I think the tune by itself, it's already pretty good. But you know what? We still need to test the drift. Spiral drift test, let's go! From my experience in the previous races, it feels usable, but a little bit on the wide side. So let's confirm over here. Yeah, no, that's wide. Yeah, there's one punch drift. Yeah, that's wide. Let's try the second time. Attempt number two, and I'm gonna try to start it a little bit sooner, hoping that I can do it better. So right here. Still wide. There's one punch drift, two punch drift. Yeah, not very good. And as usual, I gotta test it also in the opposite direction. So if this Nanex 8 would get out of the way, here, there you go. All right, let's see. Now this normally tends to work better, so it should be a little bit tighter. No, even then you still need to punch drift. Yeah, the drift on this thing is not good. Confirm. Double, triple confirm, really. After I don't know how many restarts, I couldn't find a single car that I could consistently out accelerate, but this is the one that gives me the least troubles for it to get out of the way. So hopefully this is gonna work for the time to wall test. So man, I think it's gonna be clear that the acceleration on this car, yeah, there you go. Oh, that's clean, that's clean. The acceleration on this car is nothing to celebrate either. All right, there's one attempt. Let's do it over just for good measure. So, and still with the same car. Yeah, because I seriously did like 8 restarts getting different cars. And the game was like, no, here's a 911 GT3 RS for your enjoyment. And I'm like, really? Really? All right, I think that's as clean as it's going to get for time to wall test. So you're going to have to let me know, how does this car compare to other cars in this bracket? Because it certainly doesn't feel like it's an amazing one. In general, the MP tune is somewhat usable, but honestly, nothing outstanding. And the reality is that I don't know how this car performs at pro. So if I do eventually pro it, I will also test it and figure out if it was better as an MP tune car or if it actually is better at pro. For now, that is a question for which we don't know the answer. If you enjoyed this video, you know what to do, hit the like button, all of that good stuff. And if you want to get a heart and a pin, you need to let me know if you want to see the Tesla video or not. First one to post it, you know how this works, right? Heart, pin, all of that. But that's all for now. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.
Bye-bye.